The universe is so big beyond imagination, yet composed of particles so small beyond comprehension. And those little creatures that have taken command of the planet Earth, not because of their strength, not because of their longevity, but because of their brain.
And he wanted to see our telescope. So it's, of course, it's in the middle of Chicago. You can't see very much, but it's more than the naked eye. So we climb up these rickety stairs to get to look out at the heavens. And Fred, you know, was not a young man. We were a little worried, but he charged right up those stairs. And there was this look of wonderment and just the joy of being able to do science in this fashion.
He wanted to create something of long-term benefit for humanity. The idea initially was to set up a foundation, but the area wasn't very clear in the very beginning. What we did was basically to look at it as a business. How can we gain maximum impact? And I think that in basic research, we found an opportunity.
Both Fred and I saw it as an opportunity that should be seized, that would make a difference, and that it could be built upon. And out of it, of course, came the whole program of Kavli Institutes, which are our major focus at the foundation.
These endowments are flexible. So if you have a fantastic graduate student that you want to support, if there's a critical piece of equipment that you need to buy, you can do that through this endowment.
We have been using the Kavli support to secure frontier equipment such as the helium neon gallium focused ion beam instrument.
We learn from each other, I think.
We felt we were welcome into a family, protecting us and believing in us.
How are we going to get through this economic crisis? Sometimes from the depths, you know, you learn things that really ultimately make an enormous difference in the future. And that was what we today call our strategy of catalyzing and enabling science through convenings, through meetings. Let's convene from inside the fields, but also outside the fields, get different points of view. And that led to a meetings program that we became quite exceptional at. I knew that was going to be an important meeting. I didn't know what was going to come out of it, but I knew it was going to be important.
The enthusiasm with which the Kavli Foundation suggested this idea really seemed to hit a chord and led to the announcement by President Obama of the Brain Initiative not long thereafter.
That meeting changed the course of neuroscience in the United States, and it's something I'm very proud of. But there were all these dots that had to be connected. We would have no Brain Initiative if we hadn't had that original meeting. Everything starts somewhere.
So now comes the Kavli Prize. This is really big stuff. It's very exciting.
Prizes are very, very important to call attention to what the scientists are doing, to make the public aware of the importance of science.
Great to have you back in Oslo again.
One of the winners was Millie Dresselhaus, who was at MIT. She was the nanoscience winner. She's done an enormous amount of work on carbon nanotubes and other kinds of carbon formulation. When she came up to King Harald, he said, "I hear you are called the Queen of Carbon." And she said, "Why, yes, I am." And he bowed and he said, "I am the King of Norway."
You know, it's sometimes you have a crossroads and you have two wonderful things come together at a given time. And if you can see the opportunity in that and capture it, boom, you can again do something wonderful. If we can catalyze the public engagement activities of others whose job it is to do that, we could have a much bigger impact. And I think that's been the collaboration now for more than a decade between the Kavli Foundation and the Alda Center for Communicating Science, but also between myself, Fred Kavli, and Alan Alda on a personal basis. It's been a wonderful partnership. So that's how public engagement really got going. And more recently, we have really expanded it much more dramatically.
scientists. These are people working with science societies, but they're also people who are journalists and people who are communicators and who practice different kinds of public engagement, and who all, you know, care very much about the environment for science to both advance and benefit our society.
I would say that one of the more enduring contributions of the Kavli Foundation was its leadership in 2011 in launching the Science Philanthropy Alliance.
I think by any measure, it's just been an enormous success. It can point to over $1 billion of new philanthropic funding for basic science that was influenced by the Alliance.
So the thing that is unique about the foundation and that will sustain its greatness over time are two things. One, the endowment model of supporting science through institutes at great universities. Secondly, that we're global. And those two things make the foundation unique in the world of science philanthropy. It's that which will always differentiate it from everybody else.